How's it going, everyone? Matthew back again with another review. This time we're in Dan's school. The audio is probably going to be really fucked on this one again. So I'm here talking about the new Powerful record from Tyler, the Creator, who is just about everything under the sun. Producer, artist, writer, fashion designer, movie director, pretty much anything you can think of, he does it. And I think that Scumfuck Far Away is kind of more personal approach than his other albums, especially in the way that he conducts himself and moves into a personal direction that is seen on Cherry Bomb a little bit, but definitely is full frontal here. Here he's more inclusive to his fans about who he really is. Kind of gives his more personal thoughts, especially in the first track, Forward, where he explains multiple times through the work of Rex Orange County, who delivers these lines that, if I drowned, who would know?
Who's gonna know?
But that's basically what it is. He's asking, who's gonna miss me moving on? Who are these people that follow me? What happens if I do get too inclusive with my lyrics and they can't relate to it, or my music's too strange? And he discusses this very quickly and kind of establishes this mood. It's almost like a puzzle where people are putting pieces together. It's from his first three releases, Bastard, Goblin, and Wolf. It follows storyline. Cherry Bomb kind of kicked that storyline out and just became a more personal touch. And now this is just a full personal product where he explains exactly how he feels about things. He doesn't really hold any punches. And Forward is a track where it's beauty, but it also has this great paranoia behind it. And that goes for all of Flower Boy, where it holds a schizophrenic and a paranoid and an honestly scared for the future kind of tone, where Tyler has reached this great level of success and now he's kind of looking down. He's just stating exactly how he feels about this project. And that's even in the later tracks as well. It's interesting because his style changes so much, and this could be an hour-long video just me talking about how much Tyler has changed, and there's a million other videos out there, so I just kind of want to focus more on his music. But if you're looking at his music, you have to look at his progression, his changes, and how he adapts to the new styles. This isn't even a hip-hop album, it's not even a rap album, I mean, there's barely any rap on it. It's more of a funk or a jazz album, so the way that he conducts himself, it's almost orchestral as well, and the way that he is using a lot of strings and a lot of changing tempos, and it's instrumentals can be taken more as in a film school. As the album plays, you're also listening to his ideas and how he feels, and he's still relatable even as he has this fame about him and this monetary wealth about him. He is still a relatable character. And with the following tracks later in Flower Boy and the song listings, tracks like November, Glitter, and even Boredom is an earlier track. It stands out for the way that it was a single, of course, but it also is just such an interesting track, the way that Tyler can just switch these styles up and have these great lyrics behind it as well, and be able to, even though he doesn't really rap as much on this project as he does on his other projects, obviously, this is more of like his top-of-the-line material. The tracks that he's doing now are substantially different from the tracks he's doing 5 years ago, 2 years ago, even last year. Even his featured verses on the track with A$AP Rocky, Telephone Calls. November, this is kind of the final track besides Joy Right Now, Today, which is, I enjoy the track, but I don't think it's a substantial ending as much as November. I think that is like, if you would have ended that right there, I think it would have been a great call. But I know that the way that it's explained, how the people were talking about their past, I think it's good that he at least mentions that you should enjoy today and not try to just dwell constantly in the past. Which I think is what he's trying to do now with his new albums, the way he's moving, the way he's producing, the way he's trying to produce, the way he's making his art and his clothing. He's doing a fantastic job. I'm really excited to see what he has for the next album or what he has in the future. This video will be up until probably Friday night / morning. But if you have a chance to pick up those new shoes, please go do that. I think they're already sold out. I checked today. Today is Thursday. They just came out today. I checked 20 minutes after and they were already sold out. So good luck getting on those on eBay. If you follow me on any social media / whatever my site, then you know that I'm having a show on August 18th. You should come too. It'll be fun. $5. You get to see some great artists from Pittsburgh. Bill Waves, Jago, and Live from the City are all coming through. Some really great guys. And that's pretty much it for me. If you have a chance to go see this Flower Bloom, then please go get Flower Bloom. Please buy it. Give Tyler that number one spot, please. And if you have any idea where I am, then congrats, the real ones of Pittsburgh now. If you want to check me out on Twitter and all that shit, and that's pretty much it, so.